In this video, we will be seeing that how to perform the arithmetic operations on the two values that we will take from the user, as well as the operator, or you can say the operation to be performed on those values. We will also take that from the user only. Okay, so we are going to perform some very basic operations. You can also perform some others. If you get these operations, then you can also perform some others. Okay, so here you can see. Firstly, I'm declaring all these things in my data part. I'm asking the user to enter first number because we need two numbers, and then we need to perform the operation. Like operation can be plus, minus, multiply, divide. So here you can see this is our expression, complete expression, where A, B and C are the operands, right? So this C will be the answer of, you can say, our operation, right? So we will be taking these two operands from the user, and this plus will be the operator that we will have to take from the user, whether it is plus, minus, or whatever. Okay, so here I'm doing the same thing, and then I'm taking these four strings to be printed as it is, because maybe user enters something other than this, because I'm saying the user to enter one of these, but user if enters some other operator or some other wrong value, then we have to display as it is that invalid entry. Okay, I will tell you how to do this. Then all these operations name, so we will call them in their respective procedure or label only, these strings. So inside my dot code label and above the main procedure, we do the declaration of our procedure, that is prototype. So this is my prototype of our procedure, that is name of the my procedure, my function is operation, right? This proto has to be written as it is, comma, value 1, d word, value 2, these are my two operands, and their type is d word. And this is my operator. For the operator I am taking OPER. Okay, and why I am taking byte and not d word for the operator? So you can see here that this plus, minus, multiply takes only a single byte to store data, right? We can deal and we can take them as a character, and character takes only one byte, right? So in order to deal with these operators, we must take byte, right? Because we don't need to waste the memory by taking d word, because it just takes a byte to store the data. Okay, so inside my main procedure, firstly what we have to do, we have to ask the user to enter two values. So this will display enter the first number. You will take the input from the user, move it in some other value. We will take the second value from the user, move it in ECX. I hope from now that you know how to display the strings, how to take inputs. If you haven't seen the previous video, then yeah, you can face difficulties, but make sure to see those videos, then you will be very comfortable over here. Okay, so after taking both the input of both the values from the user, we have to take the operator from the user as well, and that operator is getting stored in this, you can say, by a call read character, because the operator takes only one byte to store data. So we have to use this call read character, and that value gets stored in only AL part of EAX, right? Because of only one byte, and we are passing all these values to over this function over here. Inside with this function, what I am doing, you can say that this OPR is, you can say, the receiving the value of or receiving the operator, right? So we have to set its type as byte only. So I'm comparing that operator with plus, that is whatever the operator user has entered, I'm comparing that with plus, that whether it is plus, minus or what, right? So we have to use this conditional jumps, that is called as the conditional structures are made over here. 1, 2, 3, 4 conditional structures are here. Okay, so what we are doing, we are first comparing this operator with plus, that is if the user has entered plus, jump JE means jump if equal, that is if these two operators are equal, that is if this is plus and this is also plus, we have to go to the add label. Inside my add label, what I'm doing, I'm just displaying, you can say, the string 5 was containing addition. It will just display addition string on the screen by these two statements, and then we are adding, we are storing the first value in EX, and then adding value 2 with EX, and then results get stored in EAX only, right? And we are returning back to our main procedure. So, and if it is not plus, right, if this is not plus, then we have to skip the statement and compiler goes to the next statement. It will then compare that operator with minus. Is it is minus? If it's minus, that is, if it is equal, then we have to jump to subtraction part. If it is not equal, it will skip this jump and we'll check again that if that operator is multiplication operator. If it is equal, we have to jump to the multiplication label, right? And just like this. And if none of the operator matches, which means that the operator is neither plus, neither minus, multiplication, division, none of this, which means that none of this conditional jumps will happen, right? So in the most end, what I'm doing, this JMP means unconditional jump. Like here you can see jump if equal, this is a condition, but here is there is no condition. It means we have to rewrite this, you can say the unconditional jump, that is, if none of these operations, none of these operator matches, then we have to definitely jump to the L label. Inside my label, I am just going to display that invalid operator, because I asked the user to enter only one of these. And if none of these matches, it means user has entered some invalid operator. So for that, I'm going to do the simple L part. Inside my L label, I'm just, you can say, displaying string 4. String 4, you can see over, you have seen earlier that I was printing invalid, right? So this invalid will be printed and we'll return back to the main procedure. Nothing will be operation will happen. So inside here, you can see again. So suppose I'm going to explain one label for you. You must be familiar with addition, subtraction, multiplication, division by now. So we'll see division. Okay, so suppose our that operator is divide. So these two matches, so we have to jump where? We have to jump to div part. Inside my div label, what I'm doing, these two strings will display just division string as it is on the screen. And then what I'm doing, I'm firstly clearing my EDX. Why? Because we know from the last video and from very often, you can say, from so many videos, that we have to clear EDX before performing the division, because EDX is containing, you can say, the result of the remainder, right? So we first have to definitely clear EDX, and then we are, you can say, moving the first value in EX and the second value in EX. Why? Because division instruction cannot deal with variables like A, B, C, or you can select this. But of course, this operand, this can be the variable, but it just, you can see here, it divides EX value with the operand. Here, operand can be any, you can say, the variable, register, etc. But it only divides the EAX value, which means that one register EX is compulsory. So I'm taking both register for this purpose. Okay, I'm moving the first value in EX, second in ECX, and I'm dividing first value with second, because this is my first value, this is ECX is my second value. How this instruction works, it divides the EX value with the this operand, that is, EX gets divided by ECX and the quotient gets stored in EAX. Okay, after dividing, you are returning to the main procedure, and after returning to the main procedure, what will happen here, call right int will contain the result of the quotient, right? Because we were sending the EX value, we were returning the EX value. So call right int will contain the result of the division. Okay, so let's run it and to see if it's working fine. Okay, enter the first number. Suppose I enter 24, we can say, okay, 24, and second number I enter 20. Suppose I'm subtracting, difference is 4. And here you can see this minus, I have entered minus, but this minus is not getting displayed. It will not be displayed. It doesn't mean that your answer, your input hasn't been taken by the compiler. Your input has gone, but it cannot be displayed on the screen because this is an operator. It won't be displayed, but still it's working fine. Okay, so that's it for today. I hope you have gotten it. So thank you.